Masters, Spirit of Masters and guests. In today's nuts and bolts session, we will be talking about how do we get most out of our CL manual. For the benefit of our guests, let me explain what is a CL manual. CL manual is Competent Leadership Manual. When you initially join, you will be progressing in your communication track as well as in leadership track. For communication track, there is a Competent Communicator Manual. For leadership track, this CL manual is given. This manual is given to all members when they join initially. Correct? Agreed? Before proceeding further, I would like to know from members, do you have any questions about this manual? Do you have any questions about how do I complete this CL track? No questions?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
There are quite a few roles that come our way in the normal course.
Okay.
There are two roles that are outside the norm.
Correct.
How does one get that? Is the only one can complete this.
Correct. Fine, okay. One question is like, there are some roles like mentoring, contest chair, PR chair, membership chair. This is not on stage roles, not meeting roles, but how do I get completed? Fine, okay. Any other questions? Fine, okay. What's the purpose of this manual? Fine, okay. Any other question?
Do I do the roles to fill this manual, or do I do it because I want to?
A very relevant question. Very relevant. If we all come here to TMOD role, someone will come and brief you how to do TMOD role. But are we doing based on this manual? Not sure. That is your question. Correct. I will cover all your questions during my session.
The same role appears for various aspects of leadership. So does one role play that role differently to appeal to that particular aspect of leadership, or one plays it normally?
Fine, okay. I'll cover that as well, sir. There is a basic similarity between a CC manual, Competent Communicator manual, and CL manual. What is it?
Projects.
Both has got 10 projects. Fine, if you have got your CL manual and take the last page as listed down, what are the 10 projects you need to do? Correct? Fine. In the 10 projects, the only similarity is even this has got 10, this has got 10. There are a lot of differences. Difference number one. In the Competent Communicator Manual, generally you will be proceeding in the order CC1, CC2, CC3, like that. Whereas here it is not that way. You can do it not in the sequential order you will be doing it. You can take any role, whatever you want. Initially you may play as timer, then you may play as Toastmaster, which may be from CL9. Fine, so you cannot do it in this sequence. You can do it in your own sequence, you can do it, number one. Number two, to complete each and every project, that is if you want to complete CL1 or CL2, you should have done 2 to 4 roles to complete that particular project. Then number three, in the CC manual, there is something called online evaluation. When you give a prepared speech, there will be an evaluation by a senior evaluator who will be coming here and giving it. For CL manual, the evaluation is still there, but it is offline. All the role players who are doing their roles based on CL, they are supposed to give their manual before the meeting to a senior Toastmaster and ask him to evaluate. Fine. Then he will give feedback on the each and every role. Fine. Then now comes the question of Toastmaster Thomas. TMOD role, let us take for example. TMOD role comes under different projects: time management, planning and implementation, facilitation, motivation, team building. The same TMOD role, the action is same, but we do it with different intention. Correct? So when you do your TMOD role for the first time, you may do it for the purpose of time management. The focus will be given on time management. How do you start and end the meeting on time? How do you help the meeting to start and end on time? Second time when you do it, in addition to time management, you may also have the objective like planning and implementation, or objectives like facilitation. So in the process, you learn all these basic leadership skills like listening, critical thinking, time management, planning and implementation, all these things. This is the purpose behind which we do this CL manual. Your question?
Yes, sir.
to learn the basics of leadership skills. That is the purpose of it. One more question is, this is not sequential, so we may find it difficult to track it. How do I track it? Whenever you do a role in one particular intention, one particular project, you just write the date. Slowly after 4 or 5 roles, you yourself will come to know, if I do one role in CL2, my CL2 will be completed. Once you do that, just put a small tick mark here. Simple. That will help you understand what are the projects I have completed, what are the projects I have not completed, and in that, if I complete 4 roles in total, I will be completing the entire CL map. You will be easily able to understand this. So whenever you are doing any role, you will be doing it based on this purpose in which you are doing it. Like your regular CC manual, if you open it in project 1 or project 2, there will be project objectives here, if you look at it. For each and every project, there is an objective. Based on this, you have to do that role and get it evaluated by a senior Toastmaster. So do your CL roles regularly. Actually, it is, I generally suggest, take 2 CL roles and then give a speech. Again, do some 2 CL roles and give a speech, so that in 30 weeks time frame, you will be able to complete both your CL as well as CC. In 30 weeks, you can complete your CL and CC easily. Fine. Okay. Any other questions I missed to answer?
How does one get the outside the normal roles?
Fine. Okay. Outside the normal roles, always you can ask VPE. There are always the roles like contest chair or membership chair, PR campaign chair. You can go and ask your VPE. VPE will be able to give that. In fact, I suggest VPE. You can create a list of these, you know, like not on stage roles, and tell them what are all the opportunities available. Someone who is promoting the meeting, one particular meeting, then he can get a PR credit. Correct? All these things you can create and circulate it to them so that they themselves will know. Also, for at least for 3 to 6 months, the habit of getting offline evaluation for CL manual is not in place in our club. So from the next meeting onwards, for few weeks, I suggest Sajin attempts to announce it in the meeting, like, you know, just like we give, you know, like a few seconds for switching off mobile phone, few seconds for role players to give their CL manual to a senior Toastmaster. This way it reminds them frequently. Fine? Okay. So do regularly your CL roles and get it evaluated offline and track it. Fine? Okay. So is there any takeaway from this session? Could you please tell me one takeaway?
For us, like, I have joined 4 week back only, so I know at least the purpose and then, okay, because...
Yeah. Fine, okay, you learned the purpose of doing a CL manual, fine.
How to do that, yeah.
Oh, fine, okay, that's great. Okay, any other thing?
I have not even opened the CL manual for us.
Okay.
So we will open now and read
one. Okay, motivated to open, okay, any other? Fine, okay. So do regularly and track it so that your VP will be very blissful.